respected seniors. I find a number of you who are senior to me, who've been here for, in school for long, long before me. Chandramohan sir, Venugopal sir, Louis George sir, so many of you. Other old boys, my classmates, I find eight of them, probably the largest thing to be after the 1990 batch. Principal, vice principal, head officer, members of the staff, students, ladies and gentlemen. It's indeed a privilege for me to be here as the chief guest of the Old Boys meeting this year. I must thank the Old Boys Association for inviting me and giving me this opportunity to speak to you all and to be with you today. My compliments to the 1990 batch who are here in Spain, who have sponsored today's program, sponsored a number of programs, and as I mentioned to them today morning, your presence in such large strength is indeed a great motivation, not only for the students and staff of the school, but all of us who passed out of the school many, many years ago. Indeed, thank you. The 1990 batch is completing 25 years. And so we have the 1965 batch, I'm not sure how many of you are here, sir, who have completed 50 years today. Venugopal sir, congratulations. And we have our batch, eight of these people are here, who have completed 40 years today. And just the day before yesterday, I learned that the 1972 batch is having a big mashup for attaining 60 years of age. Congratulations to them too. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I was going through the performance of the school during the last few years. Overall, the school is doing well. The school is in very capable hands, and we are happy to see the school doing so well. But something which came to my notice is that over the years, the number of cadets getting selected to the National Defence Academy has been dwindling. I'm not sure the reason why. The common reply when you ask such a question is that, sir, during our times it was different. We had no other choice. We had very less options. Now there are so many options available. And many of them are opting for such options as engineering and medicine rather than going to the NDA. So something I put across to the principal this morning is that it may be worth taking stock of the last, say, 4 or 5 batches to see as to how many of our cadets have gotten the jobs which are better than that of their service officers. There are few amongst us who have been extremely bright, brilliant, sharp. Probably they have that options in life. But majority of us, including me, we are average people. And if you look at the number of our schoolboys, old boys, who have risen beyond the status of a service officer, the numbers will be less. There are too many options available. But then, it's not so easy in the civil street. The second part is These days, if you want to get into a good college, unless you get into a good college, you don't end up with a good job. To get into a good college, you got to attend coaching classes. Many of them, few of them start on the 10th standard, 10th, 11th and 12th, or 11th and 12th, and then go in for entrance exam, maybe taking a drop by a year. And there are many who even start from 6th and 8th standard. They are the people who go into medicine and engineering and getting into good colleges. In the science school, you do not have the facility. If somebody is inclined to go in for medicine and engineering right from 6th or 8th standard, I suppose this is not the place for him. His parents should find some other place and there he should prosper, do better. But out here, I think there is a reason for us to do a little bit of introspection. I am not saying that this is the best, the uniform is the best service. No, but uniform definitely is one of the better services available, options available for the youth these days. Not only for the products of the science school, but the youth across the country, the uniform services is one of the best. If you look at the pay and allowances, we don't calculate the CTC, the cost to the company. If you look at the status, it's a job which is respected by everyone. A common civilian, he looks up to you. If you look at the privileges in terms of canteen services, quality of life, medical facilities, I don't think there are many other services offering such privileges. Post-retirement, probably this is the only service these days where you get 100% pension without contributing towards your pension. This is one service where you can hold your head high, look someone into his eyes and say that I am in the defense forces. There is a talk, it's not a talk, probably we not got the best of deals in the 7th pay commission, but that's not the end of it. There are anomalies, number of things have been projected, some of them didn't come through. But the 7th pay commission has not been finalized and it's not been totally accepted. Just the other day, 2 weeks back, all the 3 chiefs had gone up to the Prime Minister and put across their views. Maybe some of them will, some of our requests will come through. But that apart, what is important is probably money doesn't come in the way of a serviceman's life. We have enough to live, we have enough to live, eat, and we have enough to give quality life to our families and children. I wonder how many of you know, there are a number of the defense officers' children who are doing exceedingly well. Anushka Sharma, for example, she is the daughter of an officer from one of my battalions, 16th Garwal. Priyanka Chopra, Akshay Kumar, today from Bollywood. And these children have come up because of the opportunities they have received while serving in the defense forces. You might be a CEO of a very big company. You may have loads of money. You may be traveling across the world. I wonder how much time you will be able to spend with your family. How much time you will be able to concentrate to spend with your children. How much will your children learn from you. So defense forces is definitely an option which should not be lost sight of. And with two of the senior appointments being held by us, OBA, old boys, there is no reason why we correct this anomaly which has been existing for the last few years. Yesterday I was here for the Guru Vandanam function organized by the 1990 batch. Really admire their sentiments, wherein they formally recognize the contribution of these our beloved teachers who have made our lives, who have given us our future. But sitting there, what I observed beyond what the people did for others to see was the connection between the current crop of teachers and the students. While our teachers who retired 2 years back received a lot of applause, I think the current lot of teachers received much more. And it did show us, and it did convey to me the connect they have with the teachers, with the students. So I think it's something to be. It's something that each of you as teachers and we as ex-students can really be proud of. I'm sure the school will continue the way it is, be progressing, work hard, do well, and make your alma mater proud of you, proud of each individual. And finally, I wish you all the very best for your future. May the roads rise to meet you. May the wind always be at your back. May the sun rise. May the sunshine warm upon your face. The rains fall soft upon your feet. And may God hold you in the palm of his hands. Wish you all the very best. Thank you very much.